Hey guys, welcome to the channel. This catch is a guy named Rickey Clark, or at least that's the name he gave us and the name he gave police. But he is 28 years old, supposedly, and he lives in Mount Dora, Florida. Rickey's just a loser. A creep, a loser, total pathetic waste of a human being. He believed I was a 14-year-old girl, and all he ever did was pressure me to send him nudes the whole time we talked. So there's not much to go over in the chat logs. It's pretty much the same theme, but I am going to go over, you know, some of it. But I'll start with, you know, Rickey. He hit up my decoy profile on Scout. He said, "Hello, beautiful." I said, "Hi." He said, "How are you?" I said, "I'm okay. What about you?" He said, "I'm okay. So what are you doing?" I said, "I'm just chilling. What about you?" He said, "Nice. And at work, LOL." I said, "Ah, that sounds boring. Want to text me?" Then gave him my text now number. And so then he messaged me there from his actual number, not the brightest guy. And then he said, "Hi." And then I said, "Hey, who's this?" He said, "Rickey, can I call you?" I said, "No, I hate calling." He said, "Send me a picture of you." I sent him another decoy picture. Note that these decoy pictures are of my decoy from when she was actually 14 years old. So he's looking at an actual 14-year-old girl in this picture. And then he said, "Can I see your beautiful body, please?" to a girl that just clearly looks underage. I said, "No, I've never sent that to anyone. I need to tell you something." And then he said, "Please not naked. And what?" And I said, "I'm not actually 18. I'm younger." He said, "Yeah, sure. Okay." I said, "I'm about to be 15. Is that okay with you?" He said, "I don't believe you." I said, "Okay. I don't know why you think I'd lie. I don't want to get banned from Scout." And he said, "What, your Snapchat?" I said, "I don't have Snapchat anymore." And he said, "Make one, please." I said, "I can't. My parents said I can't have Snapchat anymore because too many boys are sending me pics of their wieners." He said, "Show me more of you." So I sent him more decoy pictures, all selfies. And then he said, "All of you." And then I said, "The only picture I have of my whole body is like over 2 years old, but here, I'm like 12 in this pic." And then sent him a very, very young picture of my decoy. And then again, he said, "Show me all of you." This was a full body pic, and he's saying, "Show me all of you." He wants nudes. And then I said, "You mean without clothes?" And he said, "I know you won't do that." So not that he doesn't want it. Not that that's not what he meant. It's just that he knew I wouldn't do it. I said, "Well, I've never shown anyone that before." He said, "I just don't believe you that you're younger." I said, "Why would I lie about being younger? That's going to make boys not be interested in me." Then he called me. I didn't pick up the call. He said, "Show me your ID." I said, "I don't have an ID. I'm 14 years old. I don't even have a learner's permit yet." And he said, "Show me all of you, please." I said, "Like my privates?" And he said, "Show me you." And I said, "I already did. What do you mean by all of them?" He said, "Send me a video of you." I said, "You're making me really uncomfortable." And he said, "Please, beautiful, send me a video if you're really young." So the theme with this guy is just constantly pressuring, pressuring, pressuring. Eventually, what we had to do is Tecoy. Shout out to Tecoy. She's great. She did a decoy call with this guy. I'm going to link that in the description. But she reassured him on the call that she was 14 years old. And later, he still wanted more proof. And so we had our decoy send a video of her writing his name on her leg, because that's what he wanted, to prove that she was real. So he did end up believing 14 years old. And then we know that he believed 14 years old because he eventually said, when asking for nudes, that I said I didn't want to send nudes because he might show them to other people. He said, "No, if I did that, I would go to jail." So he knew that she was 14, and he knew it was illegal and it was wrong. I'm just going to go over some of the grossest stuff. I mean, at one point he says here, like, he's asking to see my tummy. He uses the word tummy. He says he has a tummy fetish. And then he also is asking for me to tease him. And by tease him, he meant, like, show some skin. He said, show some skin. Pull your shirt up. I don't know. He said, do you like white guys? And then he said, you want to see my body? I said, sure, I guess. And then he sent a picture of him in the bathtub holding his dick. And then later on, I had him send a video proving that he was real. He said, hey, I'm real. And it was a picture of him. It was a video of him. And then here we have, he said, do you want to see daddy's dick? And he said, never mind, I'm sorry. And I said, I guess you can show me if you want. And he said, I want to, but I really want to see my baby girl. I said, maybe later today, but only if you don't pressure me too much and if I'm in the right mood. Eventually, he does send his dick. Let me find where that is. Here we go. He said, after seeing a picture of me, he said, fuck, baby, thanks for not teasing me. I said, you're welcome? And then he said, I wish I could get teased, though. I said, like, with my words? He said, of you. I said, what? He said, do you want to see your boyfriend dick? So he thinks that he's a 14-year-old girl's boyfriend. I said, sure, I guess. And he sent a picture of his penis. And then I said, that's what a wiener looks like? He said, do you like it? And I said, I don't really care. I've never done anything with a boy's wiener. He said, can I see your boobs, please, babe, for me? So that was the first time he said a specific body part that he wanted to see. Explicitly asking for child pornography. This guy, like I said, he's an idiot. Like, he actually sent me his home address. He told me where he works. So we got everything on this guy. And this was a collaboration with Protect the Innocent. If you guys don't subscribe to Protect the Innocent, you should. She's awesome. Her camera guy is awesome. They do this all over Florida, and they're amazing. Some of the best catchers out there, in my opinion. And, I mean, they get this done so effectively, and the way that they break down and shame these predators for what they're doing is just, it's spot on. And so this was a collaboration with her. So in the video, you're going to see, this is from my perspective, because this was me taking the video. At some point, like halfway through the video, something comes down over the lens, and so there's like something on there, but you can still see everything. It's just like there's like a blurry line. And some of my angles cut off the guy's face. I was so pissed because he was denying everything, and I really was like getting into it. So my angles weren't as good. But if you go to PTI's channel after this video, at some point she will have this video uploaded too, but from her camera guy's perspective. So, and those angles are definitely going to be a lot better. He's good at what he does. Okay, with all that said, here's the video.
Just kidding.
Yep. Come on, let's go.
All right,
hope I
have the photo.
Rickey, come here. We just want to talk to him.
Go ahead.
Is your name Rickey?
Yeah, my.
We need to talk to you. Why are you talking to a 14-year-old girl?
I'm not talking to a 14-year-old girl.
We got screenshots. We got everything.
What are you talking about? This is her
father. We got everything.
Let's start being real, Rickey.
What are you talking about?
What are you talking about? You know what we're talking about.
No, I'm just trying to figure out what you're talking about. I don't know what you're talking about, a 14-year-old girl.
You show them the screenshots?
You want to start being honest, or we can go through everything right here, right now?
Oh, can we talk somewhere else?
Yeah, we can talk over here in the parking lot if you want. We're not going to hurt him. We're just here to talk to him. We're going to turn everything into police.
They're on their way.
They're on their way?
Yeah, I see you guys where you're dressed right now. I'm not fucking around.
Yeah, this is just for our identity, sir, but we're not going to hurt anybody. We're just here to talk to him.
because he was here to talk to a 14-year-old.
So,
yeah, but they can come talk to us. We're just here to talk to him about what he was doing.
You want to pull out your phone then?
I'm going to have to pull my phone out for something that you don't know what you're talking about.
Okay, well, we can get the police involved.
No, we don't. It's...
You're saying you don't know what we're talking about. So pull out your phone and show us. The little girl? You don't remember her name?
Caitlin? Why are you crying if you didn't do anything?
I'm not crying.
Why are you rubbing your eyes?
I can't rub my eyes.
Okay. You talked to Caitlin.
Yes or no? Because this can start going another way. We're a mediation group. Okay, so what do you want to start being honest here about? Well, so you could get some help or what's going on? You don't remember? You don't remember? What, you better start thinking. Because this can go many different ways.
I'm trying to remember who Caitlin is.
Okay, well then pull out your phone, jog your memory. I mean, we'll leave right now if you pull out your phone.
Pull out my phone,
don't sit here and like try to like put the text messages away. What app were you talking to her on?
Is it a text messages? If it is, I'm...
Yeah, but what did you meet on?
I believe it's that dude.
What about Scout or Meet Me?
They're all connected, so it's not.
Okay, well, you met her through Scout, but pretty immediately.
It is Rickey Clark, right?
Yeah.
You want to show us your ID?
My ID's at home, actually.
Your ID's at home?
Yeah.
Okay, the cops will get it, so.
Well, why?
Because you were talking to a 14-year-old girl, you disgusting fuck!
Are you talking about today?
The past couple weeks! Oh my gosh! You sent your dick to a 14-year-old girl.
Do you remember that?
I remember, but I didn't know she was 14 at the time.
Okay.
She told you 14 multiple times. She told you about to be 15. What does that mean? Yeah. If she's going to be 15 in September, what does that make her right now?
I'm sorry. I know it's...
You sent your dick to her, didn't you? Let's be real. Yes or no?
I'm sorry.
Well,
why did you do that? I don't know. What the fuck's going on with me? I'm sorry. Please.
How old are you? Don't look at them. Look at me.
I don't understand that. I just don't like other people in the business. We got some other guy over there fucking filming.
You think a 15-year-old girl wants someone in her business?
Yeah, I'm over there.
Okay.
I'm sorry about that. I'm fucking stupid.
Okay? The sorry fix the damage
you
done?
Because
you're a monster. Okay, I understand. You brought this upon yourself.
Yes, no, I'm sorry.
Please.
I won't.
The community is scared for their children.
Okay, I'm sorry.
How many children have you been talking to?
To be honest, this is the first that I regretted for talking to. And I'm really sorry.
After you sent her your dick.
Yes, I
am. Did you ask her for explicit pictures? What did you ask her for? Let's be real here. We have resources.
I understand that, but I'm sorry.
Okay, I'm not asking you whether you're sorry. I'm asking you what you asked her for. What pictures did you ask her for?
Her body.
Okay, what about her? Which part of her body?
Please, I don't want to get...
Which part of her body did you ask her for?
I don't want to get in trouble. I'm sorry.
I'm just asking you.
I know that. Please don't put this on me.
But this is her father.
I understand.
He wants honesty.
I understand that.
He wants honesty from you. And be real about what you did. Because we do have everything.
I understand
What did you ask her for, Rickey?
Her boobs. And I know it was stupid of me to do that. I know I shouldn't have done that. I'm really sorry.
You asked for full nude photos, too. You asked for pictures of her in the shower. That was almost the first night. You asked her to tease you? You want a 14-year-old girl to tease you?
You're fucking 28 years old, baby. What the fuck is wrong with you? A 14-year-old little girl? Do you have children? you're a piece of work. You really are. You know, it's a lot of shot logs here. Please, beautiful, send me a video if you're really young. Can I see your tummy?
Okay, I'm starting. Please.
Please
walk. Don't walk away. The cops are on their way, man.
Don't. You really shouldn't.
I'm just walking with
you. You should own up to what you're here to do.
I am. I'm over telling you. Please don't do this. I'm sorry. I won't do it again.
Okay. So you think the cops or the courts or anything like that are going to think, oh, he said he's not going to do it again.
No, I'm just...
Show me some skin. Pull your shirt up.
Please,
I'm really... Show me some skin. Pull your shirt up.
I understand what you guys are saying. It's bad, wrong. Okay, I understand. You guys know.
What we're saying is... No, what you did was wrong.
Yes, I understand that. I understand that. I'm being totally honest with you. I understand. At first, I didn't know what the fuck you guys were talking about. I understand that.
Oh, so you just talk to 14-year-old girls all the time?
No.
You weren't sure which one it was, huh?
No.
You want to pull out your phone and show us who you're talking to?
I'm being honest. That's the only one. I just didn't know who.
The only one.
I just.
The only child. Is even one okay?
I'm sorry, okay, sir. I really am. I really am.
Can you send a picture of you in the bathtub to this child?
I'm sorry, okay? Please.
We're going over the chat logs here, dude. Calm the fuck down.
I understand you would be freaking out too if this is me. You understand that, right?
This would never be us.
It would never be me. Don't ever try me like that.
I'm not trying.
If it was me, we don't go after children. We protect children.
Yes, you're right.
You're disgusting. Okay, if it were me, it would never be me.
I understand.
I don't find children attractive.
I understand that.
It's disgusting.
Okay, I'm disgusting.
These are babies.
Okay, I'm disgusting.
These are people's whole entire worlds walking around here.
Hey, I'm sorry.
You're trying to fuck them and abuse. You're disgusting.
Hey, officer.
How's it going? Is there a reason why you guys have on body armor?
Yeah, because this is dangerous what we do. We confront child predators who are trying to talk to children online. This is an organization called Protect the Innocent. I just started doing this. My channel is called Central Florida Predcatcher. They have two arrests. This guy right here sent his dick to who he believed to be a 14-year-old girl. And he asked to see nudes.
And
he gave his home address so that she could come see him.
And have you guys called law enforcement yet?
We were going to do that the moment we got here. But okay. They called for us.
Okay, you guys mind if I see your IDs?
Yeah.
So I don't have my ID on me. We're organization Protect the Innocent. We're working with him today. We've actually worked with other counties in the past. And we've actually had these people prosecuted before. We just go by Protect the Innocent. That's our organization.
Okay. I'm assuming this gentleman here is the...
Yes,
it's
me and everything.
Okay.
So we could.
I have a USB with all the evidence to give to you guys. Can you hold this for a second?
Yeah, sure.
One catcher just recently got shot, and so we've been concerned about our safety, and decided...
Just like you wear them, right? So there would be protection. Yeah, so this is the organization we go and so basically this individual, out here, he told us where he worked and kind of did everything on video and processed it.
Video of him saying I'm real and everything like that. But he told me where he works. We know it's him.
Yeah. He admitted everything.
Together?
Huh?
Are you all together?
Yeah, we're here talking together.
No, no. Are you with him? Him and that fella?
Yeah, we're all here.
Okay. Can you say whatever?
Yeah.
Thank you very much. And I take it that gentleman, or whoever that is in charge of you three or four?
We're all doing this
independently.
Yeah.
So you don't know him?
No, we know each other, but we're not under each other.
Okay, so you're all independent, right? There's no supervisor here?
I mean, they're one group, I'm one group.
Who's the supervisor?
Well, of her group, I guess it would be her.
And of you?
I'm individual.
Okay.
Sorry for touching your hands there. I appreciate what you guys do. I wish that we were going to call the cops and inform them our way, but when they saw us get out, they thought that we were here to do something wrong.
Do you have any evidence of him doing kiddie porn or anything?
Everything's on here, sir. He sent his penis to what he thought was a 14-year-old girl. He asked for nudes. He gave his home address so that she could come meet him.
Okay.
It's all on this USB right here.
So do you want to go down to PD and file a complaint?
Yep. I'll file everything, sir.
All right.
We just want to keep children safe. I like your glasses, by the way. So, I'm out of Orlando. I did the decoy work here. He's been talking to me for about a month.
Here in Mount Dora, right?
He's here in Mount Dora. I'm in Orlando.
So he sent you the picture in Orlando?
Yeah, I was in Orlando when he sent the picture. I think she has the photo with all the screenshots on it. I can't stop recording. But everything, I put it on here before coming here.
Where's Barry?
Seem like they'll be helpful, like,
yeah,
if you went and told them, like, if you ever do catches out here again.
Yeah,
we went and
yeah,
we actually just got it today, so.
Hey, did you guys give me like these rocks here?
Yeah.
Yes.
Did you is there 27 here? Copy.
Thank you for your service, sir.
Thank you.
I appreciate what all you do.
Yeah, definitely.
Huh? Yep, we're gonna come and submit
statements for me.
Yeah.
Exactly. Okay. And I got a USB with everything right here.
Perfect. I'm all about the bad guys going to jail. All right. He told you how he doesn't like this night.
And we'll let you guys know next time we're in town. We will.
But yeah, come to the PD. We're gonna get you guys a statement and tell you have to tell the whole story. I don't know how long y'all have been, whatever.
Yeah, I've been decoying for this guy for like 1 or 2 months.
Okay.
I think a month and a half.
Okay. Well, you know what?
You're the phone call.
Tom.
Yeah, and he we have a decoy who pretends to do the voice of a child,
mm-hmm.
And she called with him, and he spoke to her. And that video is on YouTube. I don't have that video. It's on YouTube.
Okay.
But everything his
that I can download.
Everything right here. Yeah. You can download YouTube. On YouTube. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
I'll meet you down there.
You know where the police department is?
No, I don't. I live in Orlando.
Yeah, I mean, know where the police department is.
No, we got.
You know where the cops are.
We got GPS.
1300 Donnelly.
1300 Donnelly.
Yes. Donnelly, take a right.
Go that way to the traffic light. Hang a right. Walk that way. Are you guys driving or walk?
We'll drive.
Okay. Right. Yeah, it's
drive that way to the traffic light. Hang a right. Follow
it up. Okay.
All right. Thank you.
He said. 1300?
Yeah, 1300.
1300.
Drive straight down the street, hang a right, and just drive straight. You can't miss it.
Gotcha. Okay, guys. It actually went really well. First arrest. Let's go. Thanks for watching the video, guys. A few things to go over. As you saw, Rickey was arrested. He has been charged with one felony, a second-degree felony of luring a minor. And he has been charged with a misdemeanor of sexting. I was informed by Sergeant Smith, which was the lady you saw at the end of the video who was telling us to come down to the station. She told me that the sexting charge might not stick. It's usually for something between minors, but they're going to make sure that that felony charge for luring a minor sticks. And if convicted, he will be added to the sex offender registry. She already talked to, I believe she said, the district attorney that they are going to prosecute this. So that's all great news. Big shout out to Mount Dora Police. It was a great response from them. They treated this with the seriousness it needed to be treated with. Orange County Police Department could learn a thing or two. And big shout out to Protect the Innocent. They are great catchers. They're amazing at what they do. And also, they're just great people. It was lovely meeting them. And it was great working with them. If you don't subscribe to Protect the Innocent already, you need to go do that right after you finish this video. Also, big shout out to Tecoy the Decoy. She is amazing. She's one of the best decoys out there. She's an awesome person too, so y'all should go subscribe to her if you don't already. A few things to go over regarding Rickey's case. Any updates I will be putting on my Instagram, so I'm going to link that in my description here. But also, I talked to Sergeant Smith yesterday, and she informed me that he actually was talking to other minors. They got a warrant to download the contents of his whole phone, so there might be additional charges pressed. But he was talking to other kids. So we have taken someone who was a real danger an actual danger to children off the streets. So it's just, honestly, it's amazing to know that we have actually prevented this monster from meeting up with and doing some sort of harm to a child. If you guys go ahead and follow me on Instagram, and if you have any questions, you can message me there. I respond to most of my DMs, as long as you're not being weird and shit. As far as that goes, have a great one, guys. Please like, share, and subscribe. I'll see you in the next video.